And whenever those tropical features do make it anywhere close to central Alabama, our WBTM 13 live Doppler that's positioned in Vance is the only one of its kind. It's real-time radar. We are able to dissect that thunderstorm and dissect that wall cloud as the tropical weather approaches. Now, we don't have anything tropical today. It probably feels like it outside in the afternoon with all the heat and humidity, but there certainly is an area of low pressure right now. This is the Bay of Campeche and the Yucatan Peninsula, close to areas of the border of Mexico and Central America. But typically when we see any kind of action that forms in the Bay of Campeche, it will impact areas of Mexico and steer clear of the states, mainly because we have that big bubble, the high pressure ridge. They call it a subtropical high because it builds typically and stirs everything tropical away from us, and we just stay hot. But we get a beautiful sunrise shot for that, right? 67 degrees your temperature right now in Birmingham, and 50s in Coleman. Gadsden this morning at 58 degrees. Really nice to get a little walk in before the heat builds, right? Just some passing clouds now. Perfect morning temperatures. Now at the beach, it's a lot hotter. Pensacola didn't even get out of the 80s. Last night. So it's not up to 80. It just never got less hot than 80 last night. Certainly a lot more humidity though along the Gulf Coast. So if you're going to hang local this weekend, the Rock the South concert going on, this is a snapshot at 5 p.m. It's going to be an excellent day to be outside. The Barrens, of course, on that long stretch at Regents Field. No problems there if you're going to be heading out to Railroad Park as well. Now, by Sunday morning, we're still going to get a great look at the sunrise with more clouds and the chance for some spotty showers by tomorrow evening. But notice, I want to pause this animation here at 10 p.m. You saw a little bit of showers kind of sagging southward. Not very impressive. Again, similar to our rain chances we just had. Not very measurable. Now, there will be a much larger weather feature that starts to develop by early next week. We start to have all that active weather in the midsection of the country, but we will begin to see better rain chances by the end of the week that actually will add up to something. Until then, we're stuck with 90 today, even hotter for Sunday, upper 80s on Monday and Tuesday. And here's how it all plays out. So the next couple of days will probably be extremely uncomfortable in the afternoon with the heat and humidity building, but a quick moving system will allow a little bit of dry air to sneak in on Monday. That's why you see that little tiny rift. Now, it's certainly not enough to bring us any kind of real measurable rainfall that we saw on Sunday evening, but it will bring our temperatures down just a smidgen, and then we look forward to that rain by the end of the week next week. Time